Welcome, dear children, to e-learning classes, Standard 5th, Subject English, Unit 2, Friendship. Hope, dear children, you have done your activity 3 as I have given you the PDF in your classwork. Now we'll see the activity 4, Grandpa's Friend, Part 2. You don't understand, John. Pop Pop shook his head from side to side and after a long pause, he said, I sat in this chair with your grandma right here when I asked her to marry me. It was so long ago, but when I sit in this chair and close my eyes, I feel she is near. The old man passed his hand gently along the arm of the chair. It's amazing, John thought, how Pop Pop can remember things from the past. In the present, he forgets almost everything. John sat down on the floor by Pop Pop's feet and listened as the old man went on. Old people mostly they forget everything in the present, but they can remember their memories as they close their eyes and sit quietly. So, here also, Grandpa used to close his eyes and sit on the chair and remember all his old memories. And the night your father was born, I sat in this chair. I was nervous. I was scared when they placed the tiny baby into my arms. Yet, I was never happier. A smile suddenly lit his old face. I think I am beginning to understand, John said thoughtfully. Many years later, Pop Pop's voice broke and he paused a moment before he continued. I sat in this chair when the doctor called and told me that your grandma was ill. I was lost without her, but the chair gave me comfort and warmth. The old man's sadness seems to grow as he recalled that unfortunate day. Here he shares his sad memories and he says that when grandma was ill and that day was very unfortunate, means sad day for grandfather. I am sorry, Pop Pop, John looked at his grandfather and said, I do see now, this is not just any old chair. This chair is more like your friend. So dear children, grandfather had so many memories. Whenever he was alone, he used to sit on his chair, remembering all those beautiful memories. John was surprised how his grandfather remembered everything from the past. Grandfather had enjoyed the beautiful as well as the sad situation sitting on the chair and when grandmother was ill and grandfather was sad and lost, it was the comfort and warmth of the chair, means it was all those memories which gave grandfather new hope. Therefore, John now realized that the chair was not just a furniture, but it was like a true friend because together they have seen the happy as well as the sad moments. Yes, we have gone through a lot together, Pop Pop said. That night, however, when John and Pop Pop were asleep, John's mom and dad carried the chair out to the footpath. It was a starless night, means very dark night. Though spring had set in, snow fell silently from the black sky and covered Pop Pop's chair with a blanket of white. Why white? Because the color of snow is white. The next morning, when John came downstairs, Pop Pop stood by the window and looked outside. A tear rolled down his hollow cheek. John followed the old man's gaze and froze. Snow covered the chair stood on the footpath out of the house. It shocked John. He ran outside. "Wait, don't take the chair," he shouted, waving both arms in the air as he rushed to stop the men from taking the chair away. Then he ran back inside and faced his mom. "Look at Pop-Pop, Mom. You can't throw out his chair. This is not just a chair. The chair has been with Pop-Pop for a very long time. The chair is like a friend." John's mom turned and looked at the old man. Slowly she walked towards him. With her middle and ring finger, she wiped away a tear. And then she looked the old man's face into both her hands and said, "I'm sorry, Pop-Pop. I guess I just didn't realize how much the chair meant to you. John and I will bring your chair back inside." They brushed off the snow with their hands and pushed the chair back inside. They placed it next to the fireplace so it could dry. John's mom stepped back then, and as if seeing the chair for the very first time, spoke to herself, "I guess it does give the room a certain touch of character." And John and Pop-Pop wholeheartedly agreed that the living room would be rather dull without this old chair. Now, dear children, here we have completed activity 4. Read the chapter and underline the hard words. Thank you for watching the video.